Hey, how's it going, everyone? This is SVT Pratt coming at you another Fortnite Save the World video. Today we'll be going over traps and trap tunnels and how to utilize different builds in different scenarios. I just want to do this a little update on this thing. I know there's a lot of trap tunnel guides out there, but there's a lot of new people into the game and stuff like that. So I want to go ahead and show some different builds. Just show a few things that I've learned over my time playing in Fortnite. What I did is I jumped in here into my Canny Valley base. This is the last, this is my only Storm Shield home base that I haven't torn down yet. I torn down Stonewood, Plankerton, and Twine Peaks. But as you can see here, this is exactly where I left it after I soloed my Storm Shield defenses here in Canny Valley. But I also built some other wooden structures over there you can see in the distance, just to show you some different types of builds. So before we go ahead and jump into all that, I want to show you the traps that I like using. There's a couple main traps that I use. I use the gas trap, I like the wall launcher, the wall dynamos, floor launchers, and the floor wooden floor spikes are my couple main favorite traps. Everything else is just almost like an added bonus, but those are the ones that I personally use, and this is the ones that I like set up. So let's go ahead and go through these real quick. The ceiling gas trap, it emits gas down into like a block area, so that tile is filled with gas. So it does penetrate the shielder husk and the little bubble husk walking through, which is great. And it just creates this area effect, and the damage actually lingers over time as well, which is awesome. Retractable floor spikes is just that. You put the retractable floor spike on the ground. When husks walk over it, the spikes shoot up and do damage on them. It's just physical damage. It's decent. If I like mixing up sometimes, if I want an area where I know a lot of husks gonna be coming in and I want to put some more extra damage out there, I'll put these out there. But normally I just stick with my wooden floor spikes. Alright, so we go ahead to the wall dynamo. These things are awesome. I love wall dynamos. Husk walk by, you stick them on the wall, they electrocute them. It does high damage and high impact on it. You can see some of the impact and damage here. It's really good for long trap tunnels too, is so when the husks are walking down, they're taking the hits on the wall dynamos, they're taking damage on it, and also it lowers their impact on it. So when they walk up to a wall launcher, their impact is already decreased from the wall dynamo, so if they hit the wall launcher, it will send them back flying. Alright, so of course here's the wall launcher here. The wall launcher I set up, I have impact knockback, reload speed. You can see this repeat itself all the way down to durability. And that gave me a good overall impact, a good overall knockback. The durability is okay, and the reload time is pretty quick. It's 4.3 seconds. Alright, and let's go down to the ceiling electric field. Now, I only use the ceiling electric fields in the beginning of my trap tunnels to kill off some of the small husks that come in, like the little small ankle biters, I call them. And they're really good with against water husks, because this does water damage. But it's reduced against fire. So if you have fire husks, anything electric is not going to be good for it. That's why I like running my ceiling gas trap, because overall, whatever you get, the ceiling gas trap is going to take them out. And you can see I have another one, ceiling gas trap here, 106. The ceiling zapper, I used to use this in the beginning of the game a lot, like towards the ends of my trap tunnels, but recently I haven't done it. It's not worth the time. It's more efficient if you go ahead and put another grass trap down than the ceiling zapper. But what the ceiling zapper does, it focuses its hit on one enemy, unlike the ceiling electric field, which goes out in a 3x3 tile radius. And this one here focuses on one enemy and does max damage on it. Everybody knows what a cozy campfire is. Then you got your two flame grill floor traps and your floor freeze traps. Now these two here, these are the traps that I like using if I want to have fun. If I want to throw a floor flame grill trap on the ground, that's just to have fun. Hopefully it's nature built, because it's fire, so, and nature is weak against fire, so I use that. And the floor freeze trap is pretty cool too. If you throw that down when the husks freeze, they take extra damage while they're frozen in place for a short amount of time. It's good for slowing down husks too. Then I have my floor launcher. As you can see here, I have a ton of impact and knockback and one reload speed and durability on it. That's just for shooting husks flying. This floor launcher, I can launch husks like three tiles high, so it's pretty tall. It's kind of funny watching them bounce around. So that's another main one I like using. The wall darts, if I have like a long tunnel or something like that, like a corridor where I'm not going to put a wall launcher on, I will put some wall darts just for extra damage. And then we go down to You can see the wall dynamos already did, wall launch already did. The wooden floor spikes. This is my main floor trap that I like using, is the wooden floor spikes. You can see here I have 3 damage and 2 durabilities on it. It does physical damage, but I'm not using it for the damage part. It does help out number wise, but I like using it for to slow the husks down by 30%. So when they start stepping on this, you're slowing the husks down. That's the whole point of this game, is to manipulate where the husks go and to manipulate the time that it takes them to get to your objective. So the more you can do, the better you and more efficiency you can do that, the better off you can be in building your trap tunnels. Alright, so in here is the ceiling drop trap. This one here, it can go up to 3 tiles high. What it does is just drops a payload of tires, and which does some damage, but it mostly slows down enemies and husks coming into it. So if it, at certain situations, I like putting that. I'm not using this for damage by any means, but that's just something for fun. Then you got the healing pads, which is garbage. It doesn't do anything. Cozy campfire is better. Patrol ward, and I don't really use that. And that's about it. Oh yeah, and I forgot your wall spikes. You can see I never even leveled them up. Wall spikes, you stick on the wall, and what it does is reflects damage back onto the husk when the husks start beating on the wall. Alright, so with that being said, let's go over here, and I'm going to show you a couple of quick builds I did, and how to manipulate the husks, the movement, and how to manipulate their time as well, because, you know, all the objectives are time, you know, defend this point for X amount of time, defend that point, and what you want to do is control the husks, where they're going, and how long it takes them to get there. Alright, so for instance, I built this here. You can see I have edges on either side. It's a big cliff. You can't go down it. And so say if the husks are coming straight across my bridge here, and the objective is straight ahead, I can actually manipulate them over a tile and down here into my trap tunnel. That's what I want to do. So sort of like funneling them in into your trap tunnel. So all right, let me show you what I did here. See, I could put up the walls. And behind the walls, I like putting either stairs or 45 degree angles, ramps going up it. So it sort of deters the smashers and other husks from beating through it, because they want the most easiest path to get to objective. They don't want to stand there and start beating through all this stuff. I mean, you might get a rogue smasher that might do it, or like a mini boss might come in and do it. But so if I'm actually putting up blockers to move the husks around, I put the wall up and I put the floor on, or the 45 up into my trap tunnels. So you can see on the other side here, I did the same thing. I put a straight wall up with the stairs, and now I have my trap tunnels. So if the husks are coming in here, what I would like to do is I would like to take a ceiling electric field, stick it right out in front. You can see it sticking right out in front of my trap tunnels. So when all the little husks are walking by, because when it sets it off, it goes by in the 3x3 tile radius. So that's a pretty big radius. So if, I mean, a husk was standing over here, they're still going to get hit from that. So what it does is it lowers the husk's health, and so when I walk against my tunnel, it's going to use less traps in my tunnel. Depending on where the husk spawns, see, sometimes the mission the husk starts spawning here. Say there wasn't a cliff, I like putting this wall at least one tile away from the little tentacles coming up out of the ground, because I don't want the. Sometimes they can destroy stuff. Two tiles if you want to be safe. But I also like what I like doing too is to say if something like this. I like upgrading these walls, and you can even put wall launchers on them. Like I said, it's all about manipulating the husks and how long it takes to get there. So if the husks are walking up into the trap tunnel, they're going to hit this, and they're going to send them flying back. So that's really really good, too, a thing to do if you want some extra, you know, time in your mission or something like that. Say if you're doing a defend the Atlas, and you have like a lot of enemies coming in here. And it sort of keeps the trap tunnel clear, because you don't want to get the trap tunnel clogged up. If it starts getting clogged up, husks are start getting through, then they're going to get overrun. They may even start beating down walls. So always keep your trap tunnels somewhat clear and try to have them trickle in instead of just pile on in. Alright, so with that being said, I got my ceiling electric field out here. Now, these next couple tiles I like doing here is I'll put some wooden floor spikes. Because I want, like I said, it's all about slowing down the husks, manipulating the time, and manipulating their path to the objective, alright? So here I'm going to put wall dynamos on it, because I love wall dynamos. Yeah, not possible. So I got my ceiling gas trap. I don't have any made, but I go ahead just for instructional purposes. I go ahead and put this up there. So they walk in, they hit my ceiling electric field. Then they have the dynamos. the four spikes to slow them down, and my ceiling gas traps. All right, so they're walking here. Nintendo's another ceiling glass trap here. They're walking down here, and I'm going to put a wall launcher. So say if my objective's like right here, and they're trying to get to it. So they have to walk through my trap tunnels. They're taking all this damage from the dynamos, the ceiling gas traps, the one floor spikes is slowing them down. By the time they get over here, my wall launcher is going to send them back out the tunnel. So it's just like almost like a rinse and repeat. They have to keep on going back and forth through the trap tunnel. Now, this little edge here, you see this, I built this little mini wall. There's a couple ways you can do this. If you want to sit there and monitor, like I like doing, is like if you want to sit there and monitor your trap tunnel, you can see this big opening. I put the little half wall there so it forces the husk closer to the wall launcher to send them back through. Here I can monitor, I can shoot, but I also can get shot. So it saves a lot of blasters standing up there, because blasters, they can stand at the end there and start shooting you. You can also change this to the can't build here, to the triangle piece. So you can see it actually blocks it off a little bit. You can still see in it, but it blocks it off more, and it still forces the husks to come to the edge here. Either way, it still does the same thing. It forces husks close to the wall launcher and getting set back, whichever way you like doing it. So say if I want more coverage, more protection from myself, I'll go ahead and do the triangle. If not, if I want more open, it's just a couple of little husks coming in, you can actually change it to that. And at the end of the tunnel too, you can always put a ramp just to make sure if it's very close to the objective. Say if it's like one tile from the objective, they will probably try beating through this, but you want them to come out here. And so if they do defeat this trap tunnel and they come out, you can always build more stuff. So say if I'm next to this cliff here, they do defeat this, they didn't get killed, the wall launcher did not send them back, you can actually put another tile here and say a 45 going upwards, and you can just put a wall launcher, or I mean floor launcher right here. So say if they come all the way through here and they don't die, and then they hit this, now they're going to get launched down there and they have to find all the way back up around again. Like I said, it's all about husk manipulation. Where's their path going, and how can you put damage on them and burn up time before they get to your objective? And this is one way to do it. So this is like a two-tile trap tunnel. You can extend it out to. Say if you have extra room, you can actually put another tile in between it, and it's just the same thing. It's going to be a long hallway with the wall launcher at the end, forcing them out. Now, if you want to mix it up too, you don't have to use your wall dynamos. You can put wall lights here, every other one. You can put wall light dynamo, and just stagger them. So when they're walking down, they get staggered, and not only they're slowed down by the wooden floor spikes, but they can hit slowed down by the wall lights too. You could do that, either or, it's great. But I know sometimes I walk into trap tunnels and I see like a wall launcher here launching husks right into this wall. I'm like, what is the purpose of that? I'm like, yeah, they hit them and get staggered a little bit, but that's not the purpose of the wall launchers. Put them at the end of the tunnels here so it's forcing them back down. Make sure you have a nice little way. And another thing too is I know a lot of people, when they play in the trap tunnels, I built my trap tunnels, then they'll come through and put these little half walls in here like this. Oh, please don't do that. it is making them slow down a little bit more on top of all this. But when I hit my wall launcher here, this is going to slap back and hit this. So instead of setting them out of the tunnel, they're going to be hitting these little half walls here, which is not fun. Let's keep it clear. It makes more sense to have it open and then set them flying back. Trust me, I did the math on both of them. Just have it open. These wooden floor spikes do more than enough to slow them down, and the traps doing more enough. You can actually, I mean, there's times I solo levels with just that, just the two tile and a wall launcher, and you can sit there and see husks pouring in, and just not going anywhere. They're just getting sent back out and dying, and let your traps do the work. All right, so that's for that straight on attack here. So that's that one build. Let's go ahead and do something a little bit different here. Say if you have a ramp coming up from the husks. Say the husks are spawning down here, and they're walking up, and they're trying to get to your objective. What I like doing is enclosing the ramp in. So they walk up here, you can go ahead and put a ceiling gas trap, ceiling field trap right here. So they walk up, any beginning of the tunnels, I'll use in the ceiling electric field. So this, like I said, it takes massive amount of DPS all around, even the small husks can take them out. So this way the smaller husks are not actually utilizing my durability on my main traps. So I can put that one there, and as they come up, I like putting three wall dynamos here. I can do this right here. So as soon as they stick their head above that breach line here, the dynamos are gonna get set, triggered, and go off, and this is gonna create this big massive kill box right here. And on top, I like putting a gas trap too. The gas trap's gonna fill this whole area up along with this. So as our husks are coming up the ramp, they're getting damage from the dynamos, all three dynamos, and the ceiling gas trap. And this back one here too, you can even see if there's like a long walkway like there is here. You can even swap that dynamo out for a wall darts right here. You put wall darts and send it out, because you know wall darts go out, I think it's like 6 or 7 tiles long. So I mean, that's pretty long distance. So enemies are coming up here. The husks are coming up here. They hit all these traps here, taking massive amounts of damage. And what I would do here is I put a wall launcher, and you can even do a floor launcher. Do I have a floor launcher built? Yep, I do. My floor launcher built here. So because you can see there's a cliff here. So if anywhere there's a cliff or anything that makes the husks fall down and they have to walk around, that's great. Because what you do is you manipulate in their time to get to the objective. The longer it takes and harder you make it for them to get to your objective, the more successful chances you're going to be. Alright, so I have the floor launcher, wall launcher, and the floor launcher is going to send them up to the 45 and shoot them out. And the wall launcher is going to do the same thing and push them all the way out. Alright, so here's another build. That's that one right there coming up from ramps. It's kind of cool. And also you can put, you can even do something like this too. Change this back to full. You can even put a wall like this. So if they come up here and they get launched out, you can even have another wall launcher here, sending them back down into the tunnel too. That's what I like doing. All wall launchers and floor launchers are doing is manipulating their path, which is great. All right, so let's go on to the next one here. Say if the husks are spawning in right here. They're coming in and they're coming over, and you have a 2-tile radius here, and there's like a little hill. They can come up around the hill. What you do is you still put your wall and your 45 to block them. And they put another one on the other side there. And almost like that, like you do in Battle Royale. It's not going to prevent them from coming over, but you can always put a ceiling there. So it does make them a little bit harder and forces them closer to the edge here. And what you can do is always stick a dynamo there or something like that, or a ceiling gas trap or something in there. So it forces the husk, instead of going all the way up this hill, it forces them down underneath. And it still gives them trouble, but you still want them to go through your trap tunnels, but it's still doing damage if they try to leak around. I know some of these hills can be tricky in the game. And on the other side, this is the second part of this too, is say if there's a cliff over here, the husks are spawning in. They're walking over here, you put a wall launcher there. You can put a floor launcher with the 45 on top. There we go. And it launches them down. They have to walk all the way around again. So that's the main thing, is manipulating the husk path and their time to the target. Alright, so that's the second type of trap I like using. Let's go over here to the third kind I have built. And this is more of a 2x2 area. Let me put my wall up there. So say if the husks are coming in from right here. Say they're walking down this little path here, spawning in here, and they're walking down. Now this little 2x2 room here is kind of cool. There's a lot of things you can do with it. I'll put a wall launcher here. And let me go ahead and build another one just to show you. I'll go ahead and put the floor spikes to slow them down. Always have the floor spikes to slow them down, because you want them to be slow as possible walking by these wall launchers so you can send them out. And we'll go ahead and put another wall launcher there. And so when a husk are coming in, they're coming in here and they're going to hit this wall launcher, it gets sent back out. And if they do make it past this one, you can actually put one of those half walls or triangle walls, whatever one you choose. It forces them closer to this one, and this one will bounce them back here, and this one hopefully will bounce them back out. Now for these other two walls, I like using the wall dynamos. Like I said, the wall dynamos are great for doing damage and also lowering the impact. So if you have a smash coming in, they have a certain amount of impact threshold they can hit. And once that threshold's hit, the impact threshold's hit, they would actually get launched back or knocked back. So I don't know if you guys have ever seen, sometimes a smasher be walking up, your wall launcher goes off, and the smasher just looks at it and smiles and keeps on walking. Well, it hasn't. The impact of that trap has not hit his threshold yet, where it would make him knock back. And that's what the wild animals do, is adds extra impact element to it. So when they walk in over here, they get hit that by that dynamo, it lowers their impact threshold, then hits the wall launcher, and the wall launcher will go ahead and spit them back out. And of course, for the ceiling, like I said, if it's inside my trap tunnel, I'll always use a ceiling gas trap. If it's the beginning of my trap tunnel, I will always use a ceiling electric field, just to minimize the little husk coming in. And that's the 2x2 trap box here I like using. It's just, like I said, just to slow them down. And if you go ahead and, if you want, go ahead and always put a 45 behind the wall that is moving them around. So when the husks are coming in, coming over here, so they want to go straight. But since you have that 45 behind it, they'll actually force them around this way a little bit more. And of course, you know, you hit the wall launchers and spin them back out. So that's a little 2x2 there. It's pretty cool. So let me go ahead and I want to show you some of the base build I have done here. And there's a couple other things I did too. There's a couple other trips and tricks. But it's always depending on the location of where the objective is and where the husks are spawning in at. And like I said, it's just about manipulation. Also, another thing I want to throw out to you guys too is the 3x3 method. If you have enemies coming in at you, if you build, say, 1, 2, 3 tiles, that's the furthest you can move them. You might be able to get away with 4, but it's highly unlikely. So if the husk is spawning over here, you have to leave this tile open and the tile after this open here for them to come through. So you're going to have to make a trap tunnel coming in this way, and you have to make a trap tunnel in that way, because it's a 3x3 rule. So every fourth tile, you're going to have open. So just keeping that in mind, guys, when you're actually building out there, building your trap tunnels. But here's a simple build I did here. You can see it's pretty complex, actually. I have a lot of stuff I've done in this. And a lot of stuff here I like just to have fun with. That's all it's about, is having fun with these guys. You can see all my traps kind of wore out from running the storm shield defenses. But the husk was spawning over here. They'll come in and they're hitting my seal electric field, spread out. And I had a couple of one of four spikes here too. But over here, instead of having wall launchers, I put darts, because this dart will be able to go down the hallway, and these two darts here will be able to go all the way over there and kill stuff that way. And in this tile here, I had a floor launcher. I can go ahead and throw one down there for you. So you can see, I had a floor launcher. So they're coming up to my trap tunnels. They will hit this floor launcher, come up this 45, and I actually made a little, I made a little basket for them. So it's like shooting hoops. The husk will go up into the basket, come down. It's my little kill box here, and just to have some fun. But so that's that. So the husk will keep on coming in, and here is what I like calling like a little separate kill box room. You walk in, so they have a straight line of sight to the objective, but this wall launcher will send them into like this little box here. And in this box, I would have 3 dynamos, either a sealant electric field or a gas trap. And here's where the big retractable floor spikes come in play. You can put a retractable floor spike here, or you can put a floor freeze trap there, or a flame grill trap. Whatever you want to choose, just to mix it up. But I like the retractable floor spikes. So the husk hit all these here, and 9 times out of 10, they'd be killed. If it's like a smasher or something, or a lobber, or not lobber, but a flinger, they have a little bit higher DPS they can handle. Higher hit points, rather, they can come back out and walk around. And if they get around to this one, and you just got another wall launcher launching back in here. As you can see, I have 3 little room kill box rooms that they go ahead and die from, and then they try to hit my objective, and it's just retractable floor spikes, wall dynamos, and sea electric fields. I have a couple zappers here. You can see the power level on these things are. That's how long ago I just threw this stuff up. And haven't used it since. You can see it's a couple people might have walked through here. This one's been used twice. This one's been used once. But everything dies within the trap tunnel here. So that's the trap tunnels coming in from this way. And the little timeout rooms, I guess you want to call them. Or trap kill boxes. You can see another one here. I have the coming in here. Pushes husk back. Takes damage by these dynamos. And seal electric field. And does more damage. You can see my wall launcher, I don't have any more. My wall launcher actually ran out, but I put another one here. They'll get sent back into this room. and die. Then they have to walk through all this stuff to get back to my objective. And you can see it's just a ton of traps, ton of rooms, and it's just manipulating the husk where they're coming in. Let's see if we can go ahead and jump over here to C or B. Let's go to B real quick, and I can show you some cool stuff over here and what I've done. And now, like I said, this is stuff in Candy Valley that's all been used. I already go ahead and soloed all this. These are traps I use when I soloed. So we have our objective down there, and as you can see, I have multi-layer trap tunnels. So husks, I give them, and this is just to have fun. You don't need all this stuff. I mean, I have husks being launched up all around. I have them pushed around, and just make it overall difficult for them to get anywhere close to my objective. You can see this. Look at this dynamo. It was power level 57. It's epic. So it tells you how old it is. I didn't really care. I was just throwing stuff up. All right. So, yep, husks are coming in here. They have couple rooms. You can see I actually used the freeze trap there, which is cool. So the wall launcher gets sent them over here. They freeze, get hit all by this stuff, and they husk die. But if the smashers do make it out, they have to walk all the way around. If they don't get hit by the wall launcher again, they have to go into the next area, and so forth. And of course here, as you walk all the way up to the end, and this wall launcher will go ahead and push you back out again. So I can see it's just about manipulating the husk, where they're coming in at, where they're going, and how long can you push them back for. Everything else is an added bonus. So I think that pretty much sums everything up that I wanted to talk about with these trap tunnels. I know it's probably gonna be a little bit longer of a video, but let me know what you guys think. Let me know if you want to see some more different types of builds. I do have some fun builds I like using, but these ones I just showed you are the basic ones. I might do a couple of other videos down the road here, just showing, you know, like how to have some fun with husks, make some bounce houses out of them, and bounce them around to places that they shouldn't be going. Just all good, pure fun. So, all right, guys, if you like this video, go ahead and give it a thumbs up. If you're new to the channel, go ahead and subscribe. I got some more content coming out, Fortnite mirrors and everything else, so stay tuned for that. Until next time, guys, see ya.